मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, हाउ आर यू ऑल? या फाइन। सो टुडे आई एम अगेन, आई एम बैक विथ अनदर न्यू टॉपिक, ग्रोथ एंड रेस्पॉन्स टू स्टिमुलाई इन प्लांट्स। What is about that, we will be seeing in this today's class. First of all, you know very well about the differences between the living and non-living organisms, right? So, there are some characteristic features. Based on that only, we will be dividing the organisms like into living and non-living organisms. Generally, what are those common characteristic features which can divide both organisms into living and non-living things? For example, first one is movement. Okay, movement, food and water. Okay, growth, reproduction. Dividing the things into two types, that is living and non-living. So, as plants are living organisms, they do not show the movement. They do not show the movement, but they are considered as a living organisms. Why? Because they are satisfying these all the things. That is why we kept plants in the group living organisms. So, today we are going to see about the growth. We are going to see about the growth and response to stimuli in plants. First, we are going to see about the growth. Growth in plants. First of all, what do you mean by growth? First of all, what do you mean by growth? If there is a change in the body of an organism, that is nothing but the growth. Okay, change in a physical appearance, physical changes in a body, we call it as a growth. So, how growth in plants will be taking place and how it will be growing and what are the differences we will be seeing now. For example, if you take a young leaf, young plant. Okay, what it will be having, young plant? Generally, you know, it is having roots, stem, leaves, etc. So this is a young plant. Okay, so they are having the leaves. Okay, they are having the leaves. So generally you can say that plants will be growing into trees. That means they will be increasing in their size. At that time what happens, roots will become very strong, very big and very fat, and stem, we call it as a stem, and for trees we call it as a trunk, and the leaves, okay, they will be increasing in the number of leaves, okay, and the stem changed into the trunk, so and it will be growing very high. Okay, so from plants to trees, so that means they will be changing in their body. The plant which is there, it's called a body. That body will be showing some changes. That is nothing but the growth. For example, does all plants and trees will be showing the same growth? No. For example, take two mango saplings. Okay, same mango plant you take. Similar, same size. And saw it in the soil. So what happens next? After few days, does these two plants will be growing in the equal range? No, one may be growing faster, one may be growing slower, but it will be growing continuously. It will be growing continuously, but based on its type, there will be difference in the growth. That means no two other plants cannot grow in the same way, in the same period of time. But they will, growth will be there, but in some it will be very fast and it will be very slow. So, and here are plants. How can we say that it is growing? How we can say it is growing? By increasing in the number of leaves, flowers, fruits, it will be giving. So by that, by seeing that, we can say that plants will be growing. And what happens to that? For example, if you see in a garden, if you see in a gardening, the persons who are doing gardening, okay, the person, they'll be doing gardening. If anyone, we are having garden in our house or anywhere like nursery or wherever it may be, they will be doing gardening. What you will be observing there? What you will be observing there? What you will be is having one scissors which we are using to cut the plants, right? And what they will do in that process? They will be cutting. They will be designing the plants which are growing in the garden. They will be cutting with the help of that instrument, and they will be making some number of designs. Okay, what happens if it will be, if they do in that way, the plants or leaves or whatever it may be, they will be growing healthy. Okay, they will be growing healthy. The process of cutting some leaves or twigs of a plant to grow more healthier is nothing. That process is nothing but the pruning. That process is nothing but pruning. What is certain plants and twigs are growing in the garden? What they will do? They will be cutting and they will be making into number of designs. Not only in the garden, if you observe in our roadsides like in the Pulan Chaurasta or in Vinayak Nagar, wherever it may be, you can see the number of plants are growing in the dividers. What they will do after certain period of time? They will be cutting the top layer, of the plants and making some designs, like it will be shaping into squares, okay, triangles. They will be making into some shapes. So that process, why they are doing that one? To grow the plants more healthier. To grow the plants more healthier. Whatever the dead leaves or whatever it may be, they will be cut off and new leaves will be growing in that place. So the process of cutting the plants, twigs and leaves of a plant to grow more healthier is called a pruning. Is called a pruning. Okay? Growth in plants. That we call it as a pruning, I said. Now, if you compare the two plants, if you compare the two plants, for example, mango, and take the brinjal. Okay, take these two plants. So what we are doing for this? We are using the seeds to grow in a new plant. Here also mango seed we are sowing in the soil and it will be growing into a mango. So if you are putting mango sapling, this is a brinjal. And for this also mangoes. Okay, this is a mango and this is a brinjal. For example, you take. So, mango plant, when it will give us fruits, how many months or how many days or how many years it will take to get a plant, mango fruit? Now, for example, this month, this is a May month, I kept mango seed in the soil. Okay, so what happens if you observe after 1 month? You can see a small plant coming from the this seed, right? And immediately it will bear the fruits? No. How much it should grow? It should grow. It's, as it is a tree, it take much time to convert into that tree from a plant. So after 1 year, it will be growing to some extent of height. After 1 to 2 years only, mango tree will be bearing the fruits. Okay, but if you compare the mango tree with the brinjal plant, what happens if we sow the seeds of a brinjal plant in the soil? After 1 month, you can see the plant coming from the seeds, and after one more month, it will be bearing the fruits. That means vegetables, brinjal. Okay, that is the difference between. It is also showing the growth. It is also showing the growth, but based on its characteristic features only that will be bearing the fruits or flowers or vegetables, whatever it is. It takes much time to bear the fruits, but it takes much very less time to bear the fruits. That is the difference. But growth is common in all the plants. And next, coming to the, for example, if there is a rose flower plant. What happens? Rose flower plant, it will be bearing the flowers, very beautiful flowers, right? So what happens after? So there is no proper water to the plant, or whatever, something happened to that plant. At that time, what happens? Whatever the leaves are there, they will be shedding down. They will be shed down. If you see, in some seasons there will be shedding of leaves, and in coming to the monsoon season, again there will be growing of leaves. So for example, now if you take a rose plant, then leaves are shedded. What happens after some days, if there is proper sunlight and everything, again new leaves are coming. Again new leaves are coming from that. If you take a trees, number of trees on your roadside, who will water the trees? Okay, who will take care of the trees? Only nature will be taking care of them. But they will be always green and providing us oxygen, etc. Okay, and shelter also. That means if once the leaf of the plant or any tree is shedding off, and in that place again the new plant leaf will be started growing. That means once the leaf is shedding off, again the new leaf will be growing in that place. That means we can say growth in a plant is continuous. Growth in a plant is continuous process. Growth in a plant is continuous process. If you need some leaves for decoration purpose or whatever it may be, you select one plant or tree, you will be plucking it off and you are using it for your use. And after few days, if you observe the leaves which where you are plucked, in that place you can see a small leaves are arising. Small leaves are arising. So that means the growth in a plant is continuous. Growth in a plant is continuous. And now there is a, on trees generally leaves are there. Okay, without leaf no plant can survive. Generally which color leaves will be there? Green color, right? Green color leaves. If for example, what happened, for suppose if there is no proper sunlight or whatever it may be, the green color leaves will be turning into the yellow color. Okay, they are turning into the yellow color. So what happens after turning into the yellow color? It will be shedding off, and again new leaf will be arising. That is a growth in a plant is continuous process. And now at the starting stage of a plant, the size of the leaf will be very small. The size of the leaf will be very small, and it can bend easily, and it will be like a light green color. And after 5 to 6 days or after 1 week, if you see that leaf, it will be of very big. It will be of coming into its, after growing, it will become a big leaf. At that time, if you compare these two, this is the same leaf and this is also grown leaf. Okay, and can I bring the stage of this size back? Can I bring the, if I want from big leaf, can I bring a small leaf of the same? Can I bring that same when it is small? No, we cannot get back to the same leaf of when it is small. As once the growth is seen in any plant or any leaf, we cannot go back to its starting point. That process we call it as a irreversible process. Irreversible process. Whatever the growth we are seeing in the plants, it is irreversible. Once the mango tree is grown into the tree, can again we can bring back that same tree into as a plant? No. Another new plant can be get from the seed of that mango, but we cannot get the same plant, cannot go back to its smaller one, cannot go back as it is when it is small. That process we call it as a irreversible process. Okay, next we are going to see response to stimuli. Okay, next one is response to stimuli. What do you mean by these two words, response and stimuli? I will give a general example to understand these two concepts. Okay, so in a classroom, while teacher is teaching in the classroom, students are listening. Suddenly, madam will be calling with your name. What happens? Some so and so name I will be calling. What you will do at that time? You will just get up from your place and you will stand. Okay? So, that is what? That is called response. That is, you are showing some reaction. You are showing some action. Reaction you are showing to the words of my, to words of my, you are showing some reaction. So, you are responding. That is nothing but the response. By hearing the name, so and so name I called, that so and so person only will be getting up. Get up from their place. That means that is nothing but the response. To my words, you show an action, show a reaction, that is nothing but the response. Coming to the what is a stimuli, which makes to response. Thing which makes to response is nothing but the stimuli. Which makes to respond. Which means to respond is nothing but the stimuli. So here, how the response to stimuli will be seen in case of plants we are see will see now. Now, plants response to light. Okay, plants response to light. So, with the help of, with the light, how plants will be showing some responses. Here, light is nothing but the stimuli. Light is nothing but the stimuli. In that example, my words are stimuli. My words are, like whatever the name I am calling, that words are stimuli and the reaction shown by you is response. So, here light acts as a stimuli and the reaction response which shown by the plants will become a response. That means how which type of plants will be showing response to what kind of stimuli we will be seeing. First one, plants response to light. So how plants will be depending on the light, how it will be showing responses to the light will be seen. First you know sunflower, right? Sunflower, everyone know the sunflower. Okay, what it is, what's the speciality of the sunflower? Generally, sun rises in the east, right? Sun rises in the east and sun sets in the west. Yes? So, how it is related to this one? How sunflower plant is related to the sun? So, what are the natural sources of light we are getting? Sunlight. Okay? Remaining sources are there, but those are artificial, but natural light is sun. So, how this sunflower is showing response to the light? Now, imagine my hand is a sunflower. Okay? My hand is a sunflower and duster is a sunlight. Okay? Duster is a sunlight. This is my hand is a sunflower. Okay? So, when the sun rises in the east, so this is the sun rises in the east, at that time the face of the flowers will be towards the sun. towards the sun. And sun slowly moving and in the evening it will come to the west side. At that time what happens, slowly as day is passing the sun also will be moving. At that time what happens, sun doesn't move but our earth will be moving, that we can see the changes over there. So as how the sun is changing its position, the flower also will be showing the position, changing its position in this way. See, finally, first of all the direction of the flower is in this way because sun is towards east. Now sun came towards the west, the face of the flowers will be also going to the west. In this way sunflowers are showing the response to the sunlight. And not only the sunflower plant, many other plants like hibiscus. Hibiscus plants also, they are having the, every plant flower is having the petals. So the hibiscus plant flower also opens its petals in the when sun rises. When sun rises and closes its when sun sets. Only in the morning time they will be opening, the flowers will be open. And gulmohar. Gulmohar is one kind of the plant, it also shows same. When sun rises it will be opening its petals and sun, when sun is not there it will be closing its petals. And one more thing, Ratrani. Ratrani, night jasmine. Ratrani is one of the plant, jasmine, night jasmine. It will be opening only in the night time, only in the absence of light. When the light is present, it won't show any opening. The blossom, that blooming we cannot see, but only in the night time they will be opening its flowers. In this way, plants respond to light. Next we are seeing plants respond to water. Next one is plants response to water. Generally plants need water, right? Plants need water to grow because they absorb. How they will be need taking water? With the help of a roots. They with the help of a roots. So with the help of roots they will be taking water and giving to the stem. Stem will be giving to remaining parts of a plant. So what happens to the plant if we water, we'll water the plant daily. What they will do, they will go, the roots, they will be in search of, they will be searching for the water. Search for water. That means where water, generally soil only will get water for plants. Okay, so they will be going in search of water. They will be going in search of water for absorbing water and minerals from the water and giving to the plant. To understand that concept, I will be explaining with a small example. You have to imagine it. Here is a coconut tree. Okay? Here is a coconut tree. And as it is a tree, it has a very big and strong roots. Okay, very strong roots will be there. Here is a pond. Here is one like pond with containing water. Okay, water. So at that time what happens, this plant, if you observe the roots of this plant, here generally it contains a pond. And what happens, the roots of this coconut tree, what they will do, they will deep penetrate, go deep into the soil, and just we can see the roots are going towards the roots are growing towards the water. Why? Here only the source of water we can see. So they will be going in search of water. Wherever the water is there, deep into the soil, they will penetrate deep into the soil and they will be going in search of the water. So in this way plants respond to the water. Next coming to the plants response to touch. Next one is plants response to touch. Here one very interesting plant is there. You may be know or not, I don't know, but here one plant which shows response to the touch. Very slightest we touch. This plant we call it as a mimosa. Mimosa plant. In general we call it as a touch me not plant. Touch me not plant. So what they will do? This plant, if you observe in your nearby houses, it will be growing. Number of plants will be growing of mimosa, but we need to identify it like it is a mimosa. So if you see, take this plant, if you go near this plant and if you touch on the leaves of this plant, if you touch on the leaves of this plant, what happens? Immediately to the touch of your, with the touch, they will be showing some response and they will be closing their leaves. They will be closing their leaves and after few minutes again they will be getting back to their original position. So in this way plants respond to the touch. Which plant is specially? Mimosa plant. In general we call it as a touch me not plant, shows a reaction, show the response to the slightest touch of our hand. Just if we touch it very slightly also, they will be showing the response and the leaves of that plant will be closing. After a few minutes again get back to its original position. In this way, growth and response to stimulus in plants will be taken place. Growth in a plant is irreversible and a continuous process, and the response to stimuli like plants response to water, response to touch and response to light. This is all about the growth and response to stimulus in plants, and I will be giving a worksheet. Go through the worksheet. Okay. Coming to the worksheet, what is pruning? What is pruning? Name few stimuli to which plants respond. Name few stimuli to which plants respond. So that how many kinds of responses are there? That shown by plants, you have to write about that. Why is growth in plants said to be an irreversible process? Why is growth in plants said to be irreversible? And like how plants show response to light, water and touch with example. With examples. Okay? With examples you have to write. Okay? So take one example of each response. And right, that means for plants response to light, one example, and explain which plant is showing what kind of response it is showing also you have to write. And plants also show response to water, I told you, with just now I explained, and touch also you write, like mimosa plant. Okay, I hope you all understood the class very well and well prepared with the subject, and I'll be soon coming with the revision video. Later you will be having the examination on this chapter. Thank you for watching. All the best.